Hey, good to see you again. Guess what? I have some bad news for you today. Did you know that even as Christians, sometimes bad things can happen? Sometimes bad things happen to God's people. There was a man in the Bible by the name of Peter, and he got put in prison. But let's see what happened.
King Herod was the king of the Jews. He persecuted Christians and tried to hurt them. He ordered that the apostle James be put to death by a sword. All of the Christians were very sad. But the Jews did not believe in Jesus, were happy, and thought King Herod had done the right thing. King Herod wanted to be popular with the Jews, so he had the apostle Peter arrested. He planned to have a public trial to accuse Peter and stop him teaching about Jesus. Peter had chains put around his wrists and feet, and he was chained between two guards. There were also guards guarding the prison doors. When Peter had been arrested, the Christians in Jerusalem gathered together to pray to God. Many of them gathered at the home of a woman named Mary and prayed that Peter would be released from prison. The night before Peter's trial, he was sleeping in the prison, chained between the two guards, when someone woke him up. It was an angel. The angel told Peter to get up and get dressed. The chains immediately fell off of Peter. Peter followed the angel past all of the guards and out of the prison. When they came to the locked city gates, the gates just opened all on their own. Peter followed the angel out of the city and to the end of a street. All of this time, Peter thought he must be having a vision. Then, as quickly as he appeared, the angel vanished. Peter quickly made his way to the home of one of the Christians, Mary. He knew that other Christians liked to meet there. A servant girl named Rhoda answered the door, and she couldn't believe what she was seeing. She was so happy and so surprised that she left Peter standing there and didn't even let him in. When Rhoda told the others that Peter was at the door, they didn't believe her. They thought she was seeing things that weren't there. But when they went and checked, they realized Rhoda was right. God had answered their prayers. Peter was out of prison. Peter spent time with the Christians who had been praying, and then he went to another place so Herod could not find him. Herod thought he could kill Christians and stop God. He thought he was as good as God, but he was not. The word of God continued to spread and flourish. Acts chapter 12, verse 24.
Wow, isn't that amazing? Even though Peter was locked in prison, guess what happened? The believers prayed and God did a miracle. Do you know what prayer is? Prayer is one of the most exciting things you can do as a Christian. It's direct communication to God. It's talking to God, telling him all about our problems. And from time to time, and more often than not, God always hears us and sometimes does amazing things. And in this story, we saw it. Peter was awakened by an angel out of jail, and God answered the people's prayers. What do I want you to do? I want you to start praying and believing that God hears you and he's going to do wonderful things in your life. If it's at school, if it's at home, or whatever you're doing, God is right there the whole time just waiting for you to pray. So guess what our chant is going to be today? You already know. I'm going to say amazing things happen, and you're going to say, when we pray. You got it? I'm going to say amazing things happen, and you're going to say, when we pray. Let's try it. Amazing things happen Amazing things happen. And that is right. Amazing things happen when we pray. Prayer is just talking to God. Tell God what you want him to do and sit back and be amazed at what our God can do. See you next time. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.